What's up, you guys? Let's go in. 짜장면.
뭐 이렇게 기관 음식들 이렇게 결안하고 우유 같은 거 하고 고기 안 들은 음식을 채식하는 사람들 많잖아요. 그런 사람들이 이제 한국 음식 먹고 싶어 하니까 여기 와서 먹어라. 그리고 제가 이렇게 소개시켜주는 그런. 아까 제가 전화 드렸더니 면에 네. 결안이 없다고 그러셔가지고.
계란 없고 다 없이는 다 할 수 있는 음식들이에요.
근데 이제 고기도 못 먹으니까.
네, 고기도 빼고 야채만 해줄 수 있는 거. 근데 짜장면 같은 이거는 기본적인 거기 때문에 고기가 들어가고 네. 이거는 이제 선택이 있어요. 야채도 되고 해물도 되고 이제 이거는 이제 선택이기 때문에 네. 돼요.
야채 간짜장 하면 그쵸. 되고 그다음에 네.
이 야채 짬뽕 해도 되고요.
야채 짬뽕 또 뭐 뭐가 있어요?
뭐 야채 같은 것들 이런 네. 것들은 다 이제 야채를 할 수 있는 거거든요. 이것도 야채.
마파두부?
네, 오케이. 이것도 잡채인데 당면하고 잡채? 이제
아, 그래요?
예, 이런 거 다 이제 고기를 빼고 할 수 있는 이건 우리는 중식이 되는 거는 네. 바로바로 하잖아요. 바로바로 국가되는 거기 때문에 네. 뺄 건 빼고 넣을 건 넣을 수 있는 음식이에요.
근데 뭐 패시 소스 같은 거 굴 소스 이런 거 못 먹으니까 안 넣고?
예, 간장 소스, 뭐 소금 이런 거로 소스 이제 와이 소스.
오늘은 그러면은 야채 간짜장 하나 하고요. 네. 그다음에 야채
잡채밥?
잡채밥? 여기 비건이라고 그러면 다 알아들으실 건가? 미국 분들이 와가지고 네, 네. 요즘에는 너무 많아져가지고 그리고 테이크아웃이 되기 때문에 네. 미국 사람 여기 꽤 많이 살거든요. 여기 인스타그램 없나요?
네?
인스타그램 같은 거 없나요?
없어요.
없어?
없어요.
아 그냥 네. 오케이.
It's so difficult in Korean restaurants because they're not used to what vegan is. You know?
So when you order, you guys, right? This is a side dish that they give you.
Thank you.
야채 간짜장.
네. 오. 감사합니다.
감사합니다. 저희가 결합 나오는데.
네네네. 감사합니다. 네. Okay, guys, so I spoke to the owner and I made sure because, to be honest, Koreans are not yet educated with veganism yet, right? So they are aware of vegetarian, but I had to make sure, you know, because I want to make sure for you guys. So the best I would say for you guys to say when you come here is that I am allergic to eggs and meat. And if you think that I can't really speak English, just say no eggs, no meat, vegan. You know, just vegetable, like that. You kind of have to, you know, work with, if you're really desperate to eat it. But anyways, I made sure, and the owner came out, the chef came out and made sure it was vegan, even though the noodle is yellow, and you would think like, why is that yellow? Like I said the same thing, why is this yellow? Like, is there egg in there? But no, okay? So when you order, they give you tea or they give you an option to order cold water. They give you this like pepper flakes, right? And you could actually put it on top of it if you want to. They give you soy sauce and vinegar. It's already on the table because it's for dumplings. But she said if there's a lot of people coming here to look for vegan options, she said she'll add some stuff in the menu. So that's great news for you guys, right? Okay, so they also give you this yellow radish with onion. Now this is a dipping sauce for the onion. They use this sauce to make the jjajang sauce, which is this, right? And they also give you kimchi. This is not vegan. I just wanted to let you guys know that this is not vegan. So when they bring it out, you just say you don't want the kimchi. Yes, I know it's not vegan, but it's here. And I also ordered the japchae noodle because this is also very, very tasty. Obviously, the jjajang is what you're here for, but also this is another option. This, I'm gonna give you actually the number, okay? If you come here, they have this like placement right here. See right here, the placement. Right? I'm gonna give you the number, okay? The number for the jjajangmyeon is 3, okay? 3 and 4 could be made vegan, okay? The difference between number 1, regular jjajangmyeon, and this number 3 is number 3, they make it for you when you order. So it's made to order. Where number 1, they make it like day before or that day, and then they just put the sauce. So it's a little cheaper. It's like $2 cheaper. I like it better because it's more fresh. And this one right here we have is number 16, okay? It says vegetable beef with starch noodles, but obviously you could just ask for it without the beef, no egg, no beef, to say only vegetable with white rice. Sometimes you could ask for fried rice, but fried rice also has egg, so ask for white rice. And I love this place because literally I ordered and it came out so fast. I think it took me like, what, 5 minutes to get my food, which is awesome. Oh my gosh, you guys. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. My mouth is watery. Guys, the way to mix jjajangmyeon with chopstick, you split the legs, okay? And you scoop. And then you rip it. And then you scoop again. You rip it. And then you, this is how you mix the noodles, okay? That's how Koreans do it. I don't know, I guess the kids do it like that too, but. A lot of Koreans do it this way. Like this. One thing I do hate, guys, is after you 비벼, oh, this extra sauce of the chopstick. I used to ask for new chopstick before, but you know, I guess you have to be environment conscious, so you just have to suck the chopstick out. Guys. Are you ready? Oh, this is so long, so I don't know. Like, I try not to cut the noodles when I eat it, but I think it's impossible not to. Let's see. I'm sorry, I have to cut it off. It's impossible to eat the whole thing like that. Guys, their jjajangmyeon here is really authentic. I mean, I had so many jjajangmyeon in my lifetime, but this is really good. I would say the best jjajangmyeon I had, seriously, was in LA. But, oh, in Korea. When I went to Korea? Oh man, look at this. Guys, jjajangmyeon is Korean's pizza, okay? You know how Americans eat pizza? Like everywhere you go, there's pizza. For Koreans, there's jjajangmyeon everywhere. The sauce has a lot of onions and chives and zucchini, okay? That's what that is. And it's sweet, salty, earthy, and crazy umami. Like crazy. And this yellow radish, it complements the jjajangmyeon so well. You know, like this. It gives you something to crunch about, you know? Yellow radish, it's like pickled and it's really sweet and sour, but it complements the noodle so well. When you order jjajangmyeon in Korea, anywhere actually, in fact, you'll always get the yellow radish. It just comes with it. Man. I'm not really a japchae person, but my kids love japchae, so I just became like a japchae mom. I gotta make it, you know? Cabbage and mushrooms, and this dish is a little bit sweet. And the chewiness. The bounciness of the noodle, when you chew it, the vegetable is like, it's like crunchy vegetable, but not raw crunchy, but like stir-fried crunchy, right? It comes with rice. It's like rice and noodle, you know? Can't go wrong. Can't eat kimchi here, you know? But they do give you onion, raw onion, and you dip the sauce like so, right? I don't know. There was like moment in my life that I actually liked this, and I kind of like stopped eating raw onion. But it's not bad. It does have a very like unique, salty, onion bitter taste to it. Something that you want to try. You might like it, you might not, you know? Guys, I hate cutting noodles. I think it's kind of like, but I have no choice here. You could also sprinkle some gochugaru, you know, to make it a little bit spicy. That's what I'm going to do now. Guys, the price here is very reasonable. It's $9.99, lunch or dinner, the same price. For japjibap, it was $8.99 for lunch and $10.99 for dinner. Okay, so guys, there's a little secret to this, okay? When Koreans finish the jjajangmyeon, right, with the noodles, you don't really eat the remaining sauce. See how the noodles are all done? Now I only have onions and vegetables left. This is what makes the jjajangmyeon good because of this, right? Majority of Koreans don't think this is leftover to take out. Like, they wouldn't say like, can I get a little container to take this home? Like, they just leave it, you know? Because it's really about the noodle. But I mean, you know, if you're tight, in a tight situation, honestly, you could ask them to give you a takeout container, or don't pour the whole thing. I usually like just pour half to the noodle, and then I save the half, and I bring it home, and then I put it on top of rice and eat it with rice. Like, why not? Guys, okay, so one thing great about this place is that the parking is right next door, and also there's H Mart next door. Right, so when you come here, you could get this takeout and go to H Mart, get whatever you want. H Mart is a Korean grocery store where you can get anything Korean, you know? Roughly around 100 feet apart away, it's H Mart. Guys, try it. And there's a police station next door, so you're really safe here. This is such a great news. I asked for takeout because I wanted to bring some for my kids, right? Now, usually the jjajangmyeon place, other places, they already cook the noodle. So by the time you go home, yeah, the sauce is great because they always give it to you separately, right? I'll show you, okay? They always give you the noodle and the sauce separately here, right? So you could always put this and you could reheat it for like, what? It's good for 2-3 days, right? But usually the noodles, they cook the noodles for you. So it's like pasta. You know when you cook pasta, the pasta becomes like really mushy. But they actually give you here, I think, I don't know if it's because of Corona or something, but they give you raw noodles. So they give it to you before they cook it. So this is what it looks like. Look, you guys, like, this is raw. They haven't cooked it. So it's like giving you fresh pasta noodles, you know, like pasta noodles, like raw. Look at this. I don't even know why I had the mask on, guys. Oh my God, I'm so used to having mask on. Yeah, so you could ask for it. Say, can I have the noodles? No cook, maybe, I don't know, something like that. So that way, when you bring it home, it's ready for you to eat it, just like how you bought it here. The noodle will be nice and chewy. Kids love jjajangmyeon. Anyways, yeah.